Good evening, chess lovers. It's Mairoku. Today, I would like to show you a fantastic and enjoyable chess battle. I believe that this game was the best one of the candidates tournament. I also would like to give you some tasks during this video. You should subscribe to my channel if you would like to watch other enjoyable chess battles like this one. Find the subscription link below. So this was the second round of the Candidates Tournament 2018. Ding Liren, a Chinese grandmaster, was the white pieces and he started with d4. Knight to f6 by Fabiano Caruana. c4. e6. Knight to f3. d5. g3. And we have the Catalan opening. Caruana also played the Catalan opening in the first round of the tournament against Wesley So. In the first round, as white, Caruana played the closed Catalan variation. However, in this game, as black, Caruana went for the open Catalan variation and not the closed as his previous game. The open Catalan the open Catalan variation would be d4, d5, c4, e6, knight to f3, knight to f6, g3, d takes on c4, bishop g2, bishop e7, white castles, black also, queen to c2, and a6. The main difference between the two lines is that in the closed Catalan, black closes the center with the force move bishop to e7. So in this position, bishop to e7 would be the closed Catalan. Meanwhile, in the open Catalan, black opens the center with the force move with this move d takes on c4. But Caruana made this bishop e7 move after castling, so this is the closed Catalan opening. So in the game, After g3, Caruana played bishop e7. Bishop g2 by Ding Liren. Black castles, white also. D takes on c4. Queen to c2. And black plate bishop and black plate b6. However, according to Stockfish, a6 is the best move for black here, because after this a6 would be a4, bishop to d7, queen takes on c4, bishop c6, bishop g5, bishop d5, queen to d3, bishop e4, queen to e3, bishop d5, knight to c3, knight to c6, white captures on d5, black recaptures, bishop takes on e5, queen takes on e5, and black is slightly better here. Guys, some questions emerge about the reliability of my analysis. I would like to tell you that I always worked together with an engine called Stockfish, which has an ELO above 3400 ELO. So I always worked together with Stockfish, and I always checked the openings from an opening book written by a Hungarian grandmaster. And I have been playing chess more than 20 years since I was 6, so this means you can trust in my analysis. And don't forget and remember that I always use an engine for analysis, and that's why my videos have 100% reliability, guys. But let's continue our game. White played knight to e5, queen takes on d4, bishop takes the rook, queen takes the knight, bishop back to f3, knight to d5, queen takes on c4, bishop a6, and white played queen back to b3. And black played knight to c6. However, according to Stockfish, knight to d7 is a bit better for black, because after queen to c2, queen f6, knight to c3, knight takes on c3, white recaptures, bishop c4, bishop e4, h6, and black is slightly better here. Guys, I must tell you that this game is one of the most perfect chess game of all the time. And why? Because in the computer analysis of this game, Stockfish 9 agrees about the 90 92% of the moves which were played by these two candidates in this match. And I have never ever seen a chess game played by humans where almost all moves that were played, where almost the moves are accepted as the best moves in that certain position by the strongest chess engine. So, believe me, this game is simply unbelievable. So after Queen B3, Black played Knight to C6, and the game continued. Queen to A4, attacking both the C6 Knight and the A6 Bishop. So Bishop to B7 only move to defend both pieces. Knight to C3 development and Knight D4 centralizing the Black Knight. But let's go back. Knight takes on C3 would be a mistake here, because after B takes on C3, Knight to A5, Bishop F4, and White is better here. But so after Knight to D4, it comes Bishop takes on D5, and White eliminates the dangerous D5 Knight. And Black recaptures. Bishop to F4. Queen to F6. And White played Rook A to D1. But let's go back. Why not takes White on why not played White this Queen takes on A7 move? Because after this, Black would reply with Queen to C6, and the White Queen is completely out of the battle, and if you can notice, the B7 Bishop and the C6 Queen are dangerous together on this diagonal. So after Rook A to D1, Caruana played C5. Bishop E3 attacking the D4 Knight. And here, Caruana played a very interesting move, which looked like a sacrifice, but it wasn't. He played Knight to F3 check, and after E takes on F3, D4, F4, and note that this move F4 is required because queen takes on F3, because if the black queen takes on F3, black is threatening checkmate. So this F3 move was necessary. So after this F4, it comes D takes on C3, white recaptures, bishop F3, and the position is equal. But let's go back to this bishop E3 move. Here Caruana played knight to F3 check, but there is another surprising move which is quite similar to this knight to F3 check move. If you wish, you can stop the video and you can write your solution in a comment below the video. So, the question is, what would you play as black after the move bishop to E3? What would you play as black in this position? Write your solution in a comment below the video. Ready? So the other move after bishop E3 would be, the other solution would be knight takes on E2 check. Did you find this? And after knight takes on E2, D4, knight to F4, D takes on E3, queen takes on A7, bishop F3 attacking the rook, rook to D7, bishop D8, rook to D3, E takes on F2, and this is also a check. Rook takes on F2, bishop E4, and this position is also equal. So, and this position is also equal. But let's return to our original game. So in the original game, after this bishop F3, white continued with rook to D3, bishop C6 attacking the white queen, and white replied with queen to B3. It is important that queen takes on A7 would be a mistake here, because after queen to F5, the black queen not only attacking the white E3 rook, but the black queen also aiming the G2 square with the protection of the C6 bishop. So that's why this queen takes on A7 move would be a mistake here. So after After queen b3, black played, queen to f5, attacking the d3 rook. c4, not only gaining space, but the white queen also protects the d3 rook. And with this move, white is slightly better here. The game continued. Bishop to e4. Rook to d2. Queen h5. And white played f3. And this move, f3, is the only move to avoid checkmate. Because this move opens the second row to the d2 rook in order to defend checkmate on g2. Bishop takes on f3 and white played f5 here. However, here there is another variation which would give an advantage to white after this bishop takes f3 move. So after this move, there is a variation which would give an advantage to white here. If you wish, you can pause the video and you can write down your move as white after this bishop takes f3 move in a comment below the video. Ready? It is a very unusual and strange move, so don't worry if you didn't find it. In the game, white played f5. However, according to Stockfish, the best move here would be this bishop to d4. So the best move here would be bishop to d4. Can you imagine this? Or Stockfish is crazy? Stockfish went mad? Of course, it is not. Because after this bishop d4, it comes c takes on d4, rook takes on f3, queen to c5, king g2, rook to d8, queen to d3, h6, g4, bishop to f6, king to g3, queen to c7, h4, g5. And this is a very long variation, but after some more moves, black is better here. But let's turn to our original game. So in the tournament, white played f5, and Caruana replied with bishop back to c6. Queen to d1, offering a queen exchange. Queen to h3. Rook f to f2. h6. queen to f1, queen to g4, again refusing changing queens, rook to f4, queen to g5, rook to d3, queen f6, bishop to d2, bishop back to a8, h4, queen to c6, and now black is threatening checkmate, threatening a serious attack, it is true that this is not a checkmate, but this queen to a1 would be a huge attack. So king to h2, bishop to d6, attacking the rook, rook back to f2, bishop e5, bishop to c3, bishop takes, white takes back, rook to e8, f6, g6, and after that move, the game ended in a draw. As I told you at the beginning of the video, this was a very strange game because neither white nor black can earn serious advantage during the game. The position was dead equal almost during the whole game. What do you think of this game? Like, subscribe to my channel, and thank you for your attention. You can find the link of my channel below the video.